Hello and welcome. I'm Connie Douglas from Great Stamping with Connie, and it is Monday evening at 7:30, and this is That's Fancy. Time where we craft together and play some with some new toys, maybe, or some dyes, some layers, some technique, something fun, something crafty, something a little bit fancier than just some simple stamping. So time and a place for easy crafting, and there's a time and a place for, you know, things that are a little more stepped up. So tonight is the time and place for things that are a little more stepped up. Tonight we have some 3D items that I'm going to share with you. I've got a couple of little treat holders that you can make for Easter. And you may be thinking, good grief, Easter already. Yeah, it's coming. Hey, Leonie, welcome. Hi, Lorna. Oh, too many L's. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. My mouth's not working yet. I need to get it warmed up. You have Connie withdrawal. Oh, no, that's terrible. It hasn't been that long. I'm here 3 times a week, Lorna, and you usually are too. So we'll give you your Connie fix tonight, I hope. So, yes, as I say, so tonight we are going to make some little treat holders for Easter. And you might think it's a little bit early, but it's always good to get a little bit ahead of the curve. But I'll be honest, it's a little bit about me tonight. I am involved in a craft sale this Saturday, like, you know, 6 days from now, 5 days from now, whatever that is. And of course I'm totally prepared, right? I'm all ready. Everything's packed, ready to go. Yes, it's all organized. Yes, of course not. So I have been working on some things, and when I was trying to think about what we would do tonight, I thought, hey, you know what? Why not share? These are fun. These are cute. Let's share these. So if, as things are starting to open up, around here, maybe you're going to gather with some of your family members for Easter, and won't that be wonderful? And so if you're going to set your Easter table, maybe you'd like to put just a little treat at the table for everyone. I got you covered tonight. Okay. So I am going to, the paper on my desk is doing weird and wonderful things. I don't know. It's got a little bump in it, but I don't think it's going to mess up our crafting. So we will be good. And look, there's one of the little guys hanging out in the back. We're not making that exact one, but that was one of the bits of my inspiration. So I will show you him a little bit later. We're not going to start with him. We're going to start with a little different one. But that's not a mouse. That's not going to help me. Okay, let's flip us down so we can get to some crafting here. Alrighty. So I don't know how many years ago, a number of years ago, I made this little guy, a little Easter chick, and I don't even remember what was inside of him. Looks maybe like probably some little chocolate bar or something. Anyway, something that fit in there was inside of him, but I saved this to be a pattern and a template and a reminder of something that I could make. So of course, this was an embossing folder that's long retired, and this is a half, two halves of a scallop circle, and this was a little flower punch. And so all of these things are kind of gone now, but you know what? We have others, we have new ones. Oh, I just noticed, Leonie, you said morning. Yes, it's morning for you. It's evening here. Leonie is in Australia, so it's morning for her and evening here in Canada. So I took this little guy as my template and my ideas, and I made this little guy. So there he is. So this is what we're going to make tonight, and we're going to... I'll show you step by step how we do him. And I have a Lindor chocolate that I have put in here. And it is, you'll notice it's not falling out. I did attach it to the bottom with a little glue dot. So just so it stays put. But these would make really cute table favors on your Easter table. Or they could get popped into a basket Or you could, they're small. Oh, thanks, Leonie. He is cute, isn't he? They're small. You could even, you know, hide these along with some of your eggs. You could put little chocolate eggs in there too. And then he could be a little decoration for your Easter eggs. If you have, I know, Lorna, you have grandkids. Leonie, I'm not sure whether your kids, grandkids, or where you, what stage your life is at. But anyway, okay, so let's get started. So we are starting with a piece of cardstock that is 2 inches wide by 7.5 inches long. It is scored at 3 inches and 4.5. And you can adjust this center portion. If you're putting in something wider, you can make it a little bigger, you can make it a little smaller. You have another inch on your 8.5 inch cardstock, so you could make it a little longer. If you want your chick a little shorter, you could cut it a little shorter, or whatever works for your treat. The next one, I'm going to actually show you how I take a treat and create a package for it. So you have big kids that love treats. Yes, I have some of those as well. I have big kids and their partners, and who doesn't love treats? I love treats. I'm a big kid that loves treats. So we all love our treats, don't we? And at Easter, we need to have treats. So I've brought in the little Stampin' Cut Emboss machine, the mini, and I am going to bring in I didn't put the package in here. I'm going to bring in this embossing folder. Yes, it's got little leaves, and it's comes in a 2-pack because the little ones do. And I, of course, did not write down the name of it. So we're just going to flip to the handy dandy little little catalog here to find out that it is hopefully in here. Yes, greenery. So it's got the leaves, and then the other one has some greenery up both edges. Whoops, didn't mean to bounce your head like that. Okay, so this is greenery, and I am just going to put my cardstock in up to the first score line. Okay, you can do it more if you wish, but I wanted to leave the bottom flat, and I didn't, but I could have done this side and the other side, but I didn't bother. So I'm just embossing the front of him. And let me just see. Gosh, I haven't used the mini with the embossing stuff. I have to double check what plates I need. I need plate number 1 and plate number 3. That's the beautiful thing about these new die cutting machines. They tell you right here what you need when you are using standard embossing folders, which this is. This is not one of the 3D ones. So you need plate number 1, which I'm going to put into the bottom here, and then I'm going to put my embossing folder in. And we always do it with the hinge going in first, okay? So you always want the hinge going in first, regardless of what machine you're doing or what embossing folder you're using. And then I'm going to put plate number 3 on the top, and then I'm going to wiggle you and jiggle you, and hopefully you won't get seasick. It's just a little bit of wiggling, isn't it? Run that through. We're only doing one of these right now. So hopefully you don't get too seasick. And then we have, that's kind of feather-like. If you don't have this embossing folder, you can use any embossing folder. You just want to give it a little bit of texture, something that looks kind of sort of a little bit chicken feather-like, I suppose, or just something to add. I mean, you could do it just plain, just flat cardstock as well. Use what you have. But if you don't have anything and you would like this folder, you can order it in my online store. Just head over to greatstampingwithconnie.com. It's all right there. So once we have that, we are just going to fold it on the score lines. Okay, just to get it ready to go. It looks like I embossed. Nope, it looks like I don't know where I, oh yes, that's the end of the folder. I thought that was my score line. Okay, so I embossed it a little past the score line, but that's not the end of the world. It's fine. And then, gosh, you know what? Didn't write down the name of this one either. I think it's the fancy tank topper, maybe. I may just leave my catalog out and handy because I didn't really write down any of this stuff. Yes, it is the fancy tank topper stuff. And I'm just going to use that to punch both ends of this. Okay, get that stuff out of the way. And our little chick is coming together. And then what I used was, ta-da, can you see that? There we go. The strawberry punch, maybe easier this way. So there's your strawberry and there's the leaf and the little topper for your strawberry. And there's also a little strawberry blossom. So I have gone ahead and punched these things out. So I punched two of the flowers in Calypso Coral and I punched one of the leaf in Daffodil Delight. And I am going to cut that in half. And then I will fess up, I used a retired Owl Builder punch for my circles, but you can use any circle punch or circle dies. You just want some little circles for the eyes, okay? And then the beak is just, it started out as a rectangular piece of cardstock. I just scored it in the middle, folded it in half, and I just hand cut into the little peak of the beak. Can you see him? Okay, there's the little beak. Alrighty, so the easiest way or the fastest way, I suppose, you can absolutely use liquid glue to put this guy all together, but I am going to go really quick and easy. At least that was my thought. And I am going to use glue dots. I think I actually put these on with liquid glue the other night, but tonight I'm using glue dots all over the map here. They are quick, they are easy, and they're super sticky, so they will hold really well. There we go, there's my eyeballs. I need to cut this in half. I had scissors, there we are. Okay, to cut this in half, and then we're just gonna put the flat side on the top and the little ruffly wing stuff underneath. So I'm gonna put a glue dot right in the edge here to stick him onto. This is the new roll, so it's really fat. So my ribbon's a little bit tight right now. So pick that up. And I'm just gonna put it down towards the bottom, kind of leaning down a little bit. There's no right or wrong. You can put them wherever you like them. Use my old roll of glue dots, but I think it's going to run out pretty soon. I thought I would pull out a new one. So I kind of like this angle a little better. I'm going to just swoosh him down a little bit further. There we go. And then I'm just going to put a glue dot on one petal here because a lot of this petal is going to stick out. But I covered two of the petals. Okay, and then the other three stick out the front for his little web foot. I think, actually, I don't know that chickens have web feet, do they? Ducks do. I don't think chickens do. Oh, well, this chicken has this kind of feet. It's just a baby chick. Hello, Donna. Welcome. We are making some Easter treats and we have already established that it doesn't matter what your age is. When it's Easter, we all like treats. We all like treats at any time, but big kids, little kids, we all like treats. So and I'm just going to get glue dot onto the eye. That did not work well. And stick it right up a little bit towards the middle. We don't want his eyes too far apart. He'd probably look a little goofy. The other way you can work with these glue dots, I should show you where, if I could find where I put my tip, my pick tool. school. Sorry, it's just on my other table. In my my near panic for the craft sales this weekend, I'm not ready. If you just get your take a pick tool under the edge of the blue dot and flick it quickly, it tends to come up quite nicely. And so I'll just stick that on there. And then we're gonna put this little eyeball down here. There we go. And then we will also attach. Oop, that didn't work too well, but I think it's okay. The beak, the same way. And we'll just put that under the eyes. Thanks. None of they are cute, aren't they? And now he is all ready. And I have a Lindor treat here. So as I said, I did put a glue dot on it just to hold it in place on the bottom of this. So I'm just putting a glue dot right in the, you probably can't see that, but it's right there. And then I'm just going to stick that right down onto there. And then it's held in place. Okay. And then I used some of the metallic mesh ribbon. On this old one, I had used white baker's twine, and I could have used white baker's twine, but I didn't have any sitting in my ribbon bucket. And I saw this and I thought, oh, he could have like a little silver tuft of hair at the top. And this is super easy to tie. So that works out well. And I just tie it into a reef knot. Anybody that was involved with Girl Guides, Girl Scouts, any whatever it's called in your country. So left over, right under and pull, and right over, left under and pull. That's a reef knot. Okay. And then we will just trim it short so it kind of sticks up in his little hair tuft or feather tuft, whatever it is that chicks have. A little decoration. There we go. And there you have it. That's it. Quick and easy. And look, little treats inside. So we love those. So I am trying to make some of these for my craft sale on Saturday. Did I mention it's this Saturday? Yes. So there we go. Okay. So that is the first one that I wanted to share. Now I'm just going to clear away some of these supplies. And I have a second one to show you. So I have some of these little, they're little cookies, Crepes Oriental. I think they were out for, was it Chinese New Year maybe? I'm not even sure. Anyway, they were little cookies in a box, and they are all individually wrapped, which was sort of the key. And they are chocolate vanilla or coffee vanilla or something. I don't remember what flavor they were. I tried them. They're light and delicate. It's really nice with a cup of tea or a cup of coffee or whatever. So anyway, I got those and I thought we could make a little cover for them. The next project is inspired by this guy, which I had made a number of years ago. And these, I think, had Lindor chocolates in them when I made those. I have another one over here. So yes, a Lindor chocolate would sit right in there. So you could do it with a little round chocolate in this little box, but I already made chicks for my Lindor chocolates. So I didn't have any more Lindor chocolates that needed containers. So, but I did want to use the bunny because I thought he was cute. So we'll use the bunny, but we're going to wrap these in almost like a belly band. And then we will attach the bunny to that. So there's our second inspiration. So for him, you need circles, and you can use any size circles. This is about 2 inches. This is an inch and a half. This was half an inch, but I did a little test run with one, and I thought I'd make his little cottontail a little bit bigger. So I used a three quarter inch circle on this one. Okay, you can make it any size you like. And these circles also don't have to be, 2 inches and 1.5 inches. They just have to be different sizes, and then they will look bunny-like, and that's fine. And then for his ears, I use the leaf from the tulip punch. Okay, so there's his bunny ear there. Actually, I guess it's actually this way. But anyway, the tulip leaf is what I used for the bunny ear. Again, you can use anything. There's a lot of leaf punches and dyes. And so anything that you have that cuts out something ear-like. If you go looking, not at what your dyes and punches are intended to be, but what they could be, you will probably find something that could be a bunny ear. So there you go. That's your mission if you choose to accept it. So let's start with the belly band. I also decided to stamp Happy Easter onto this little guy. I think everybody knows that these are going to be Easter treats. That's probably fairly obvious, but I decided to stamp Happy Easter on there. And I used a wish for everything. So in here we have Easter and we have Happy. So I just put them together on a block, and then I have Happy Easter, and it was nice and small. There are other sets that have a Happy Easter that's also nice and small, but this was the one that I chose and just stamped it right across the bunny's body. So, okay, so when you want to make a covering for something, you just need to measure it, really, is where you start. So I measured this, and it is 1.25 inches across, and then it is 1/2 inch wide, and then another 1.25 and another half. So I find I have to write it down, otherwise I miss stuff. So I wrote down 1.25, half, 1.25, a half, and then you want it to overlap. So I chose to have it overlap 1/2 inch so that my Stampin' Seal Plus would fit on it, and I could just use that to attach it. So I added another 1/2 inch. So 1.25 and a half, and 1.25 and a half, and a half. And that totals 4 inches. And then I just measured this, and I didn't want it to cover the whole thing. I just wanted it kind of through the middle section. So that's 3 inches. So we want a piece of cardstock that is 4 inches by 3 inches. I will just grab my trimmer here. And I decided that I was going to use the pattern party paper, which is all of the host set. And this I know is just sort of blue, but there's cool black and white on the back. There's all these pretty stripes and these colors. And what else is in here? There's just tons of, bright and pretty colors in this pack that you can use. And I thought that was great for spring. So good for Easter, good for spring. And I decided that that's what we would use for our bunny wrappers. Okay, so let me get some of this out of the way. And then I was thinking too, stuff like this black checker. I love gingham. I love gingham and paper. I don't necessarily want to wear it. Gingham was all the rage for shirts and stuff back in perhaps the 70s. But I do love it for designer series paper. So very happy to see this. And we have other gingham as well. But anyway, back to this guy. So we need a piece that is 3 inches tall and 4 inches wide. Okay. So I am going to cut this at 4 inches. and 3 inches. Okay, and then once we have it cut, we want to move over to scoring. Okay, so the light gray blade, and we are going to score it at 1 1/4. And then we're going to add the half, so 1 3/4. And then we're going to add another 1 1/4, so 3. And then the last half, 3 1/2. Okay, so that was scored at 1 1/4, 1 3/4, 3, and 3 1/2. Okay, and set this to the side. And then you're just going to fold it on all of these score lines. Okay, and then we have a little wrapper. So this half inch is the extra half that I added so that we could overlap and join it. Okay, so this is just going to make a little wrapper that this will fit inside. Okay, so just like that. Now I could probably get it to go in after I attach it, but it's probably a lot easier if I put my adhesive on here. I'm going to put it on this half inch on the outside because I want this covered and to be inside. And as I said, I am using Stampin' Seal Plus. So this one is a little stronger. Anytime you're doing 3D, you probably want to use Stampin' Seal Plus because it is just a stronger adhesive. Okay. I'm going to put that all down there. And then before I join it, I'm going to actually put my, does this have an up and a down? It almost doesn't, but I always sort of think that this flower should be pointing up. So we'll make this the up for what it's worth. No one's likely to ever notice, but I will do it that way. So then you just fold this in, fold this over, and you just want to line this up with the edge and give a nice press down. Okay. Now I'm giving a nice press, but I'm being gentle about it because we don't want to squish the cookie inside. Okay, so there's our cookie inside our wrapper. Okay, and then we just have to make our bunny. So you could add perhaps some sponging on the edge of your bunny if you want him to have a little more color. I have a winter bunny. Some of the bunnies around here are starting to turn brown again. Yay! Spring is coming. but you can make your bunny whatever color you want. So I made my bunny white. He's clearly not a chocolate bunny, unless he's a white chocolate bunny. But as I said, if you happen to have any of the circle punches, they are super quick and easy for this type of project. You can use those. Or if you have the layered circles, they will work. I'm using the punches tonight just because it's quick. While I'm sitting here, you don't have to watch me die cut a whole bunch of things. That right into that one. So there's my bunny body. That's a very bunny body. And then I need too many punches here. We're done with this guy. He was the chick. Where did my tulip go? Here is my tulip. So we need two of these for the ears. So I am just going to bring that in here. One ear. Licking stuff everywhere. And then I'm going to punch a second one. There we go. Okay, and same as with the chick, I put a lot of this together with glue dots, but I did use some Stampin' Seal just to attach this, just so I could get a little more coverage there. And you're just going to overlap the top as much or as little as you want, maybe not quite as much. I never know. It's like, does that look like a bunny? Sure, that can be bunny-like. And then we will bring in the glue dots again. And you just want to, You can put these either way. You just want them to be like opposite. Okay, so I think I'm going to do them the same way as this. So I'm going to put, you want the glue dot on the front of this. So I'm going to press that on there. And then this can go, and you want them fairly close together at the top. So sort of put it out to the top of his head. Sorry, it's a lot of white on white, isn't it? But you can see I've got it kind of coming out the top of his head as opposed to over to the side. You can do them to the side. I thought it looked a little odd when I had mine further to the side. So then I put it back towards the top. This one might be a little too much to the top. We may have to bend it. Anyway, and then you want the other ear to go the other way. So I'm going to put the glue dot on the top here. There we go. And we'll do this one up here. I think this is going to work. There, kind of looks like bunny ears, I think. His head, maybe he's looking to the side a little bit. Anyway, so there is our bunny, but he needs a cottontail, and you can coordinate his little cottontail to any color in here. So there's Flirty Flamingo, Poppy Parade, Granny Apple Green, you know, whatever you like. You can make them all different. I may just go with Flirty Flamingo again because actually I have all the colors of cardstock sitting here. I pulled them all out because I thought I would make a few of these, but... I only have 30 flamingo ink here right now, so I will do this. And this is, as I say, I decided on a 3/4 inch cottontail for him, and I popped him up with a dimensional. Okay, again, you don't have to do that. I just thought that was kind of cute to pop it up. So I probably should have stamped on him first, but I didn't. So here is my Flirty Flamingo ink. You see this? We're also in the camera here. And ink him up. You'll notice I put this on an angle. If you can't get it straight, go on an obvious, like, okay, clearly I was not trying to make it straight. That's why it's on an angle. It's always safer that way. There we go. Okay. Nobody thinks that I was trying to stamp that straight and messed up. That's obviously supposed to be on an angle. So there we go. It had one woman that would come to my classes and she said, yes, sentiment should always be dramatically crooked. That way no one thinks you messed up. If you try to get them straight and you sort of miss, then it just looks crooked. But if it's dramatically on an angle, then clearly that was how you tried to do it. So I thought, ooh, I like that. And then that's just going to go on here. I think I'm going to put him on with dimensionals. So you just want dimensionals down the middle. I guess you could put them on here, but I'm just going to go right down the middle area. And I think, his whole body, yes, pretty much his whole body will cover that. So you don't actually see a whole lot of this, but when they turn it over, they will see the pretty paper, and if they pull the bunny off, they would see it. So I'm gonna put 4 dimensionals on here, which is a fair number, but just because it's, you know, it's on something that's not completely flat and it's 3D and it's getting moved around, I don't want my bunny to hop off. So I thought we'll just put lots of dimensionals on. These little guys are harder to get the backs off for somehow I don't seem to get the same leverage with my fingernail to pop the backs off. Okay. And we will just put him on there and give him a nice little push down. And then we will see that he is crooked, I think. So I'm just gonna lift him up and move him over a little bit. So anyhow, when you're working at angles, things don't always line up the way you think they do. There we go. So there's our little bunny with a little cookie treat inside. Okay. And our little chick with a little chocolate treat inside. And you could put those at your table. When you set your table, you can put those there and everybody could come and have a little sweet treat, or you could you could hide them around the house and people could have an Easter treat hunt for them or whatever you like. So that was, look at that. Gosh, we're fast some of these days. I wasn't sure how long that was going to take for crafting, but apparently we're done and it's only, it's not even 10 after 8 yet. So what else should we do? Anybody have any other Easter treat ideas? I could try to pretend to remember how to make this box, but I haven't. I could show you how to make a box. I think I have enough cardstock here. I think this would be big enough. We could make a little box. Anybody want to make a little box? Anybody think they might do the bunny this way? Thanks, Leonie. I'm glad you like them. I thought they're, you know what? They're cute and they're quick and easy, which is kind of nice, because I don't know about you, but when I am entertaining, you know, I'm always behind. Yes, always behind. That's how it goes. Okay, you know what? We could even make a box with this, although it's not as sturdy as cardstock. So let's, okay, I'm winging it here, Lorna, just for you. If I mess up, you can't blame me. Where did my ruler go? I cannot do anything if I don't have my ruler. Because I probably have a pattern for this somewhere, but I don't know where. Okay, my ruler was just here. And now it's gone. Oh, because it flipped over. Look, see, my ruler is white on the back, but it's bright red on the front. That's why I keep it. It's Crime Stoppers. I've had this for years, but it's bright red and I can usually find it, except when it's like this, then it just looks like white cardstock. Okay, so if you want to make a box, okay, so we're gonna grab a chunk of paper here so we can write down some measurements. So this box is 1.25 by 1.25. Okay, so we have 1.25, and then we have 1.5, and then we have 1.25. So that is this measurement, and then which is this 1.25, 1.25, 1.5. That's that piece. And then up here we would need this piece, and over here we would need this piece, and then inside we have, oh, it's backwards how I did it. Okay, hang on, let me see if I could, I can do this. So we went this way with three pieces and this way with three pieces. I can't do this under pressure. It's not working well. Okay, so we've got 1.5 there, and then 1.5 here, and 1.5 here, and 1.5. I don't think I'm doing this right. And 1.5. That's way too many 1.5s. Isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. Let me see if I do this. 4, 5. And then we need this piece. Oh, maybe that's what it takes, is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So this is 1.5. So this is 1.5. I'm just going to make it all 1.5, because that way I don't have to worry about messing up. It's just going to be a little bit taller. And then I could figure out how to cut it down after I make the first pattern. So I think if I do this, so I need a piece that is 1.5 and 1.5. So that's 4.5, right? 4.5 tall by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.5. Oh, I don't have that big a piece of paper here. We might have to make it with this. We'll give it a try. It just won't be quite as sturdy, but this is 7.5. This will be big enough. I'm gonna give it a go, and we'll see what we get. Don't you love when we do this, that's fancy stuff, and we just, wing it? Let's just see what we get. So, look, I even need to pull this arm out since we now have to be 7.5. I gotta make some more room on my desk. Okay, 7.5. We're gonna do it in gingham because that was sitting right here close by, and it is more than 7.5 inches. Hey. Well, not yet, Lorna. I'm only amazing if it turns into a box. But you know what? We're just having some fun. And this is how I do it when I create boxes and things. But there's something about having people watching you live. Just puts a little more pressure on things. Okay, so now I want to score it. So put that at the top. I'm going to score it every 1.5 inches, seems to be what I should do. Since I decided I was just doing it all at 1.5. So that's 1.5 and 3 and 4.5 and 6. Okay. And then the last 1.5 is 7. And then I will score it at 1.5. And 3. Okay. No, I'm having so much trouble lifting that tonight. I think because I'm at a funky angle. Okay. Think we're done with this because I think I'm going to hand cut this. You could probably do this with your trimmer, but usually when I make a box, I just hand cut everything because usually you're only cutting, a couple little pieces here and there. This one, the way I've kind of created it, I think we're going to be cutting off quite a bit of it. But I needed to do that while I figure out how to do it. Do you follow that? Okay, so this is going to become our box. Do I have too many sides? I have a full overlap. So that's a lot of overlap. I maybe didn't need that much overlap, but that's what we have. So we're just going to go with it. And then I need a piece. This is the overlap. I need pieces. According to my picture, I just need one piece. And I don't know that it matters with which one. Maybe we'll just start taking some stuff off and maybe it will become perfectly clear. Or if I cut the wrong place, then it will become perfectly clear that I messed up. I'm gonna do it on this side because this is just a little bit easier to see where my score lines are. And we will just start. So I am not wedging anything just yet because, again, working on the flight. And normally when I would start something, I would do it with just, computer paper or scrap paper or something. I wouldn't actually start with designer series paper. So if you're doing this, that might be on the recommended list. Do it just with paper and make yourself a pattern. See if it becomes a box. And then do it with your good designer series paper. But I'm being brave and bold or foolish or anyway, I'm diving in. So here we go. So see, it's coming kind of together. We need flaps. We actually only need flaps to go in one end, I think, don't we? So we need two pieces here. Okay, so I'm gonna. Oh, maybe I didn't need this whole piece. I might end up because there's no lid on this. This would make a box. So I probably didn't need that third piece, that third section. But anyway, we will see in a moment. I'm cutting this middle one out. I don't know whether it matters or not, but this is the one that I'm cutting out. I've made the decision. So I'm just going to bend this back so I can get in here a little bit easier to cut it. And then we will see that we have this coming together and this. Oh, no. No, see, I messed it up. I wonder if I can salvage it on the other end. If I cut, I probably should have left four on this side. So I'm just going to cut up this score line here. Because it doesn't have a lid, I might still be able to almost salvage this. It's going to have an opening. So this covers here. There should have been one more to come over here so that there's no gap in here. And then we don't need these two top pieces. Okay. But normally you wouldn't want this here. I shouldn't have cut that piece out. So we should have had four. Shall we do one more? Let's do one more. But I'm going to take these off because we totally don't need this side. So we don't need as big a piece of paper either. Now that we have it, we can measure this. So I need one more here. And this last flap probably doesn't need to be that big. It doesn't have to cross the whole way, but it can. It's not the end of the world. So let's just measure this. So this is 7.5 by 3. Me see what I have for paper here. Look. Oh, we've got this lovely check paper, or we could do it in blue. Okay. I think it's. Might be 7.5. We'll see in a moment. Seven and a half. Yes. Sneaks it in. 7.5 by 3. Okay. And then we are going to score at 1.5 this way. I'm going to score at all the 1.5s across. So score at 1.5 3. Okay, little ticky. And 4.5. And six. There we go. Okay. I think we got it this time. So we will fold all of this. That's not well scored, is it? That should be even. I don't know whether my cut is crooked or my score line, but let's see if we can get this straightened out a little bit. And then we will fold all of these away. Okay, so there's all of those. And now again, it's easier to see here. So now I want to cut, I think one of these we don't need, but you know what? I'm just going to cut all of these first and we'll see how it goes. So I'm just cutting straight up each score line for now. We can look at tapering some of these in a moment once we get this figured out. So this is going to come together. They are going to overlap, and then these pieces will all fold in. And there's our little box. So now I could cut that top quarter inch off as well, now that I know what I'm doing. But I'm going to take one of these off where I have my overlap because it's a lot of bulk, so we don't need one of these. Okay, so I'm going to cut that off. Okay, and then that will come together and this will all fold in to make our little box. So this can be the back. So then you want this one to be the front so that you have nice coverings everywhere. So we've got a nice seam there, and we have all of our joins at the back. Okay. Look at that. Brilliant. Yes, brilliant. It only took two tries. So now we have to glue it together properly, though. So you can glue all of these down. You don't have to, depending on what I'm doing with it. Sometimes I will glue the first and the last, but. So this is the back, this is the front. So this is going to be my very last one. So I want the blue on the inside of him, not the outside. I'm going to use my Seal Plus again. Just make sure I get him nice and taped. And the first one that you're going to put in, you definitely don't want here, because then the bottom of your box will be sticky. So just be careful you don't set that down. But I'm just going to put I'm going to put a little bit of tape on each edge of this, and that'll just kind of hold it in place. Okay, so I've got tape on the bottom here, that's sticky, and then on the outside here, and then this we want on the inside, right? So I'm going to put my tape on here, and this I want to be nice and held down. I don't want gaps, so I'm going to put it on all four sides there. And then the easiest way to join this is just to fold it in half there, and then you can just fold this over, and then you'll get a nice join. Okay, so there's our box, and then we just want, this is the one that's going to be the last piece in. Other than that, it doesn't really matter which ones you do first. We only put the tape on the blue side, and you just want to make sure it's going down as square as possible. There we go. And then the fourth one will go down, covers over all of that. And then you just want to, in this one, you can just reach in and do it with your finger. If it's a little bit deeper or something, you can get your finger to the bottom. Using your bone folder will work well. All stuck down. And then if you were doing these with Bunny, you could just attach your bunny right to him like that. So we'll just put, you know, this one you want to be careful because obviously your bunny doesn't go all the way up. So I'm just going to put some dimensionals into this area of my bunny. I'll put a few down here again because it's 3D and it's going to get moved around. I'm using a little more adhesive than I might for a flat card that doesn't get moved around and manipulated as much. And then you just want to make sure that your bunny doesn't drop below your box. Okay, so we don't want our bunny, and I'm exaggerating, but you don't want him down here or your box won't sit well. So if you have your box sitting on the table and then you put your bunny up to him and attach him, except let's be careful because of course I don't have it straight. That is straighter because my Happy Easter is on an angle. Messes me up every time because my eyes, you know, see the angles and stuff. And then just give it a good push. And there you have it. There's our little treat holder with a box. And it only took two tries. So, you know, I can punch little bits out of here. This will become something or other. It's not far off, but it wasn't quite right. So there we go. So there's our bunny with a box and our bunny with a belly band and our chip that holds a chocolate treat. Okay. Alrighty, let me bring me back in here to be with you. Where's, oh, my mouse is not cooperating here. Okay, there we go. Spotlight. Hello, Terry. Welcome. You missed all the fun I was creating on the fly. It's like, oh, look, we have extra time. What should we do? Let's make a box. Ah, I got a pattern for a box, but it all turned out. Yes, you can watch the replay and laugh at me. First box didn't quite work out, but we got it for the second box. So it's all good. It's all good. Anyway, there are some quick and easy Easter treats for you to adorn your Easter table or whatever you like. So I hope you enjoyed those. And thank you so much for joining me this evening. It's, I guess they're kind of fancy. Anyway, seasonal, getting ready for Easter. Look at that. If you go and you make those this weekend, think how far ahead of the game you'll be. That would be nice. Oh, thanks for the thumbs up. I like that. Anyway, thank you again for joining me for That's Fancy, and we will see you all again really soon. Bye for now.